well, this is for people who have probably either got good flexibility naturally or who've done some yoga previously. I put the blanket down because it's a fairly hard floor, but if you have carpet, you probably wouldn't need this. Bolster is ideal, but if you've got some cushions, quite solid, or roll up some blankets or fold some blankets. You can even use books here, a stack of books, phone books used to be good, but of course we don't have those anymore. And something for your head a little higher, so extra blanket or books. So I kneel in front. Back of my calf is a little caught, so I'm going to release the back of the calf out. Spread the toes. Just let the head of your leg sink down to the floor and get a little bit of length here through the torso as well, because you want to lengthen it backwards. Place the hands onto the side of your hips and lower yourself backwards. About here, I'm going to lift your body because I'm going to tuck it towards the back of the knees. Knees can come up until I get my spine down. When this settles, then the knees can relax down. It might take a second, or it might take a bit longer. This is adjusted so it supports the head and neck, and the arms down by the side. We should be comfortable. If your back is catching, then you need to come up using your arms. See if you can go back a second time, but if it catches, I would suggest not doing it. Or you could lift the, put something else higher underneath your back. And so 5-10 minutes here. If you become more fish with it, you could increase the timing. To come out, slide your hands back, press the hands into the floor, lift your chest up. Coming up, part your knees a little more, toes together, and extend the trunk forward into Adho Mukha Virasana. And then you can slide your hands back, turn your toes under, and pike up. Walk back. If you can't touch the floor, you can turn around and put your hands onto the bolster, chair, or bricks. Just stay there until you're ready to come up.